Want to know how to turn any object into a light source in Blender? Today, I'm going to show you how it works using a node called the Emission shader.
So first of all, to access this shader, we'll need to go into our shader editor. So I'm just going to change my timeline here from this clock shape into the shader editor. Then I'm going to press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm just going to choose a cylinder. You'll notice that our object isn't smooth here, and to fix that, you can just right click and choose Shade Auto Smooth. The reason I chose Shade Auto Smooth here and not Shade Smooth is because if I was to choose Shade Smooth, it would smooth everything evenly, whereas Shade Auto Smooth will fix these hard edges for us using this angle you can see in the bottom here. If you ever want to edit this angle, you can just come to your modifier properties and edit it here. Then I'm going to come down to this thing which says Line Style and change it to Object. Then to add a new material, we can press plus new. But right now, if I was to left click the base color of our default shader and change the color, you can see no change in the viewport here. So I'm just going to change to Material Preview, but if you're a Blender 4.2 user like me, your object will appear black like this. To fix that, all you need to do is come to the render properties, change your render engine to Eevee, turn on ray tracing, and then in the ray tracing settings, turn our max roughness to 1. Then I'm going to change my render engine back to cycles since I'm going to use cycles later. And now you can see it's working properly. If that didn't work for you, it may be that unfortunately, Blender 4.2 isn't compatible with your computer. In which case, I would highly recommend using the next latest version, which is Blender 4.1. We're not going to use this principle BSDF, so I'm going to left click it and then just press X to delete it. As always, our object will go invisible since we don't have anything plugged into our material output surface, which determines how our object will look. So I'll press Shift A and then under shader, this time we're going to choose emission. And this here is a node which allows us to create a light source out of our object. So I'm going to plug the emission into the surface. So as always, it's green socket into green socket. And right now you can see it's plain white, but if I go into my render preview here in cycles, notice how my render engine set to cycles, you can see if I increase the strength to something like 4, it's going to get brighter. You'll also notice if I press Shift A, then under mesh, I choose cube, and I press G and X to move it along. When I move to the side here, you can see that the lighting from our cylinder is affecting our cube. When I go back into Material Preview, you'll see this effect is no longer there because Material Preview only uses its own lighting and won't rely on any lighting objects in the scene. As I mentioned, we can change the strength of our light source here with this strength parameter, and we set it to 0. You'll see it will just go completely black or null. You can also change the color of our light source here, and you can even use textures as always for the color input to create some cool effects. For example, I could press Shift A, then under texture, I could choose noise texture. And if you remember, the noise texture has a cool rainbow effect for the color. So I'll plug that into the color, make sure I set my strength to 1. And then when I go into the render preview in cycle, and maybe I'll turn the strength up to something like 4, you can see how we have a lot more color in our lighting here on this cube. I'll go back to material preview. I'll unplug my color just now. Something else you can do is you can actually make things darker by turning this strength value to a negative number. So if I change this to minus 4, you can see that that's now made this face of the cube darker. This can be handy if you want to control your lighting in certain areas and make certain things darker. This is not very realistic though, so do be very careful when doing things like this. But it can be great for creating some pretty stylized results. But yeah, that pretty much covers all you need to know about the emission shader inside a Blender. In the next installment in the series, I'm going to be covering what I think is hands down the most useful shader in Blender called the Principal BSDF node. So if you're new to the channel and don't want to miss that, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on that video. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.